We have seen that the case against Kevin Watts rests on 4 points. 1, his confession. 2, the testimony of his girlfriend, Jackie Ross. 3, the testimony of Kevin's cellmate whilst on remand, Jerry Brown. And 4, the evidence of former forensic scientist, Dr. Timothy Billings. All of this evidence we have shown to be tainted. It is the opinion of an eminent legal expert that Kevin Watts could not have committed the Archibald Gallery robbery. So then, who did? To find out, we turned to this man, who agreed to speak to us on condition that his voice was disguised to prevent identification.
Do you know who committed the Archibald Art robbery?
Yeah, I do.
Who was it?
Harry Tadger and Barry Burton. They done the whole thing and got off scot-free.
How do you know this?
I drove the van.
So you were involved too?
No, I drove the van.
This picture of Messrs. Harry Tadger and Barry Burton was taken before they suddenly moved to Puerto de la Mile End, a suburb of Marbella on the Costa del Sol. They now live here in this luxurious villa. We decided that I should fly out to Spain and talk to them. In the course of the interview, they destroyed our camera, but fortunately not our microphone. In addition, we were able to obtain these pictures of the meeting from an English couple who were on holiday there at the time.
Mr. Tadger, Mr. Burton, I'd like to talk to you about the Archibald... Please don't do that, Mr. Burton. That's not going to help your case at all. No, you, please, Mr. Tadger. The Archibald Gallery robbery, which I... Thank you, that is quite enough. Quite enough. Thank you. Please, let go. There is an innocent man languishing in a... Please!
At this point, I lost consciousness. After 2 days in bed, I followed another line of inquiry, which led us to here, the home of a renowned Andalusian private art collector named Juan Luis Cordoba. Posing as a television arts programme, we went to view his collection.
The table in my hotel room. But anyway, that's enough about me. What a marvellous collection.
Thank you.
That's an El Greco, isn't it?
Si, he's El Greco. A beautiful painting.
Yes, fascinating.
Si, fascinating.
Do you know, I thought this painting had been stolen from a gallery in Glasgow.
I think I know which one you mean, si. The one you mean is very similar. It's a variation on the same theme.
It's identical in every detail.
Well, it's not a very big variation. I think El Greco painted the week before.
Ah, now, here's a familiar friend. That's a constable, isn't it? A big sky, wonderful landscape. Oh, what's that pole doing in the centre of the picture?
Hole?
Yes, there. About the size of a postcard, I would have said.
Oh, see, si, of course. It's very typical of constable.
Is it?
See. Never waste a piece of canvas, that man. Even if it had a whacking great hole in it, he simply painted round it.
This painting was stolen from the Archibald Gallery in London.
No.
Yes. They have the piece that exactly corresponds to that hole.
It's another one.
No, you know very well that it's the same one, Signor Cordoba.
Okay, so what? Possession is 9/10 of the law, and since I possess 9/10 of the painting, it is mine, no?
No, Signor Cordoba, I don't think that's an argument that would stand up in a court of law. Would you like to explain about these other paintings? Because I have a feeling that that Munnings is rather similar to one that was stolen from the Mansell Gallery in Norwich.
Oh, thanks, Signor Cordoba. Thank
this you. One here, this Samuel Palmer.
The Archibald Gallery has started proceedings against Signor Cordoba. But what of Kevin Watts? Why was he arrested for what was obviously a highly professional job? This man, a policeman, says he knows.
I was on the investigation into the Archibald art robbery with Inspector Dickens, and there was a lot of pressure to make an arrest. Heck of a lot of pressure, which is why, in the end, we picked up the Watts lad.
Why was there so much pressure?
It was the beginning of August. Inspector Dickens wanted to go on his holidays. Canaries.
I'm sorry?
Canaries, same place, 2 weeks every year.
Was this usual?
Well, he was always very nervous of flying, phobia about planes, you know.
So you're saying that in order to unburden his mind of an anxiety that would disturb him while he was flying, Inspector Dickens quite deliberately framed an 18-year-old schoolboy?
Yes.
Inspector Dickens repeatedly declined our invitation to be interviewed. For this reason, I took up position near his house and waited for him to appear.
He's coming.
Um,
Inspector Dickens. Inspector Dickens, I'm David Lander from Channel 4's programme. This is David Lander. I wonder if I could speak to you about the Kevin Watts case.
Go away. I've got nothing to say.
Inspector Dickens, can you explain why it is that you arrested an innocent 18-year-old schoolboy?
It's sub judice.
No, it isn't sub judice, is it, Inspector Dickens? The trial ended 18 months ago. Inspector Dickens, why wouldn't you speak to us? Do you know who actually did commit the robbery, Inspector Dickens? Inspector Dickens?
Look, let me pass, please.
Inspector Dickens, all we're after is a chance to have one or two words with you about the Kevin Watts case. All right?
All right.
Right. Now, Inspector Dickens, do you still maintain that Kevin Watts, an 18-year-old schoolboy, is guilty of a robbery which... Inspector Dickens? Inspector Dickens, could you please come back, Inspector Dickens, and release my handcuffs? Inspector Dickens? Inspector Dickens, does the name Harry Tadger mean anything to you? Inspector Dickens, you might at least leave the key. No, it's no good, we've lost.
An hour later, the fire brigade arrived and released me. Kevin Watts, however, remains under lock and key. In the light of the evidence unearthed by this programme, it is to be hoped that the Home Office might reopen his case. Certainly his parents, Yvonne and Brian, are eagerly awaiting his release.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Mm. Oh, it would be nice to have him back, wouldn't it?
Mm. Be nice to have the floorboards back.
Yes. And your magazines, eh?
Yvonne, the magazines don't matter.
But you said they were an investment.
I never said they were investment.
But you've nearly got the set.
Yvonne, they are not important.
Of course they're important. You're like a loss. Without them, he is, you know.
Yvonne.
Ever since they've been gone, he's not known what to do with his evenings. Have you, Brian?
Kevin Watts' ordeal provokes an alarming question. How many other innocent men are being detained at Her Majesty's pleasure?
Hundreds, I should think.
Isn't that a cause for great concern?
Perhaps. But on the other hand, if we're going to have this much overcrowding in prisons, the more innocent men we've got in there, the better. They tend to be a lot better behaved than your hardened criminals.